This Vigillo video will focus on the second section of the Vigillo CSA 2010 Inspection Root Cause Scorecard. You can pause, rewind, or fast forward at any time. This section is entitled Root Cause Overview. In this section, we will define root causes and see exactly the impact of each root cause on important carrier measures, such as violations, CSA 2010 points, increased expenses, and lost time. We'll also look at which root causes result from driver-controllable behavior. Let's look at the pie charts first. The top left pie chart shows inspections broken down by root cause for each inspection. This is the same as the pie chart we saw in the previous section. Notice that if you add up the 16% of inspections triggered by observable defects plus the 17% for inspections triggered by speeding, you get 33%. That 33% of all inspections are listed as driver controllable. We say driver controllable because the driver is able, in the vast majority of these cases, to control, reduce, and eliminate these root causes through that driver's own direct behavior. We'll talk about how in a minute. Naturally, these inspections result in CSA 2010 points from violations. The second pie chart graphically shows the results of these inspections based on the CSA 2010 points caused by each inspection's root cause. In this pie chart, you can see that for speeding, 37% of CSA 2010 points were caused by inspections with a root cause of speeding. Look back and you'll see that only 17% of inspections were triggered by speeding. For this carrier, speeding triggered inspections caused more than twice as many points as other inspections. Let's look at observable defects. Observable defects accounted for 16% of all inspections for this carrier, but those same inspections accounted for 39% of all the CSA 2010 violation points. If you look above the pie charts, you can see that the two driver-controllable root causes, speeding and observable defects, accounted for 33% of all inspections, but they account for 77% of all CSA 2010 points. The final root cause category, ISSD Other, accounted for 67% of all inspections, but only 23% of CSA 2010 points. ISSD stands for Inspection Selection System score given by the FMCSA, which determines in part if your trucks will be inspected. One note about ISSD score. If your fleet's ISSD score is high, meaning 50 or over, your fleet's vehicles will likely be targeted for more inspections, thus leading to more violations, which in turn leads to higher ISSD score and so on into a vicious cycle. Understanding your inspection's root causes will help to break this vicious cycle. Question. Where would you recommend this carrier focus its energy if it wanted to reduce its CSA 2010 points? Are your results similar? Let's talk about definitions. What are observable defects? What exactly do we mean by speeding and unsafe driving violations? Over on the right, you'll see helpful explanatory text for each of the three categories and also links to see lists of the specific violation types and questions. To see a list of all the speeding and unsafe driving violations, click this link. To see a list of all the observable defect violations, click this link. Let's look at the table under the pie chart. There's a table of additional carrier level information here. You can see how each root cause contributed to your inspection count, your violation count, your CSA 2010 points, and your increased expenses and lost time. Finally, in this section, we see a chart that shows CSA 2010 points by basic, by root cause. For example, all the purple you see in these charts represents points that were caused by an inspection triggered by an observable defect. Without these observable defects, it's quite possible that the inspection would not have occurred at all, and therefore no violation points would have been found. On that basis, you'll notice how many points were caused by speeding and unsafe driving, shown in orange. If this carrier had reduced speeding, and therefore reduced inspections triggered by speeding, they would have reduced their unsafe driving basic, no surprise there. But they also would have reduced their vehicle maintenance basic, their fatigue driving basic, cargo, and driver fitness as well. It is certainly worth studying your fleet's chart in detail. How many basics would be improved by a reduction in the two driver controllable root causes for your fleet? Look for the orange and purple. We'll see root cause information by individual drivers in the next section of the scorecard. And by the way, each section of your scorecard has its own video help. That wraps up this video help for this scorecard section, Root Cause Overview.